So you walk into your classroom and you open up your laptop, and then Chrome is waiting for you with all of her 56 tabs that you know you're going to have to use at some point that day. And you think to yourself,
there has to be a better way.
There is a better way. Let's explore how you should be using Google Chrome. So the first thing you should be utilizing if you aren't already is Chrome profiles. You can see the different profiles available. Each profile is tied to its own Gmail account. And so I've got one for my personal one. I've got my new EdTech classroom work profile, as well as a sample student profile that I'll talk about in a little bit. The nice thing about this is each profile has its own bookmark bar. It's got its own homepage. It's got its own extensions. This fixes a few problems. Let's say I wanted this document to be in my work Google Drive. This current Google profile is attached to my personal Gmail, which means it's attached to my personal Google Drive account as well. So if I click make a copy, it made a copy and put it in my personal Google Drive account. And if I wanted to move it over to my business account, I'd have to click on share and then actually share it with my work email, which was super annoying. Had I just gone over to my work account and then opened up that doc that I wanted to make a copy of and then made a copy, it then goes into my work Google Drive, and I don't have to do any of the weird sharing or anything like that. Another situation where a Chrome profile will actually help you is if you want to show the student perspective of something. So here I've got the teacher view of Google Classroom. Now, I want to show my students the student view of this because they're going to get a little confused if they start seeing all of my teacher stuff, or I don't want them to see any grades or anything like that. But I still want to explain this project to them. So in my profiles up here, I have a fake student account for Roger the Robot. Excuse me. I'm not fake, I'm very much real. And then I add that fake student account to my Google Classroom. So now I just pull up Google Classroom from Roger's profile, but I still have my teacher profile up and open. I haven't lost that. I haven't had to log out of my teacher profile. And then when I'm done showing this, I can just close out of this tab, which is the student profile. And so just make sure you add that student profile to whatever online accounts and classes that you have, and then you'll be able to do it. In addition to organizing some things using the profiles, there are some other time-saving hacks built into Google Chrome that I didn't actually know about for a while. Have you ever wished that certain websites that you use all the time actually had their own app, one that you could actually put at the bottom of your dock on your computer? Google Chrome actually lets you take any website and create an app out of it. So let's say we want a Google Classroom app. If I open up the website that I want to create an app for and then go to the three dots up here, there is a more tools option, and then you're going to create a shortcut. We can call this Google Classroom, and the key is to click on this open as window. So do that and hit create. And now you can actually see this little window. This is not a Google Chrome window. It's almost like a window just for Google Classroom. And so I can go in and do any of the things that I want to do on Google Classroom. Now, to make it so it shows up on your dock on your computer, it'll create a folder in your home directory called Applications. This one's a little bit different than the Applications where all of your actual apps are. But you can see like the main where you find your documents and your downloads. There's a folder called Applications, and then you're gonna see Chrome apps there. And then I've actually created a few here. You see Google Classroom there. If you click and drag that down to your dock, Google Classroom is now an app that you can click on. And so this is what it looks like. You can resize it. And that's nice because now Google Classroom or your gradebook or your LMS or whatever it is not getting lost in your tabs, but instead is its own separate app. You can even switch between Google Chrome and that app by using Command and then Tab on your computer and then go back and forth. It's Control Tab if you're using a PC. If you find that your computer and Google Chrome are running abnormally slow, you can actually find out which tab is the thing that's taking up most of your computer power. So I've got a handful of tabs open right here. And then if I go over to my three dots on the far right, and then I go down to more tools, you want to click on the task manager. The task manager is basically showing you everything that Google Chrome is running. And if you click on memory footprint, you can sort it to see which aspects of Google Chrome are taking up the most RAM or the most computing power. Now, I can't close out my GPU processes. I can't actually close out the browser. I need to keep Chrome open. And I don't want to get rid of this extension that blocks ads on my computer. But the first thing that shows up that I can get rid of is this YouTube video, Learn, Explain Everything. Maybe I had that up from yesterday and then forgot to close it. But even having it up is taking computer power. And so I can click on it and then click on End Process. And then it basically just kills that tab. You can actually, if I go back to Chrome, you can see this is the tab that was that video. And so now it's not taking any computing power. I can leave it there and refresh it if I want to come back to it later, or I can just close out that tab as well. And then just go through and see, are there certain tabs that I'm okay closing out that I'm not using right now to hopefully speed up my Google Chrome and computing power. And the last time-saving tip is, do you hate when you get to a new website that you've never been to and they're like, hey, do you want to get notifications from us? And you're like, no, I don't even know what website this is. Why would I ever want notifications from you? I don't want notifications from any website. You can get it so no websites can even ask you if you want notifications. And to do that, I'm gonna go up to my three dots. I'm gonna go down to Settings, Privacy and Security, Site Settings, and then down where it says Permissions, there's a little section that says Notifications. If you click on there, you have several options. I recommend checking the don't allow sites to send notifications. And so if you have that checked, no pop-ups will ever come up asking you if you want notifications from this website. So you've separated your home and work worlds with Google profiles. You've found some ways to optimize Google Chrome a little bit more. Now it's time to tackle all those tabs. One of my favorite things to do when I have a lot of tabs is to actually group them together. So here I've got an American history video I want to show my students, a Wikipedia article I plan on talking about, and a website that I want to refer them to. And so to group these together, if I click on the first tab, hold shift, click on the second, and then click on the third, I can now right click on it and then go to add tabs to a new group. And so they're going to say, well, what do you want to call this group? Let's call this group history. And then I'm going to make this blue. And then I am going to hit enter. And so now whenever I click on the history group tab, you can see it expands and collapses those tabs. If you really want to get fancy, you can actually put an emoji in lieu of the title or in addition to. So I've got this American flag emoji. I'm going to highlight it and copy it. And then I'm going to right click on my history tab. I can just replace history with that American flag emoji and hit enter. And so now I know that little American flag tab group is going to be all of my American history resources. You can do this with all the classes you teach each day and then keep that toolbar a little bit more cleaned up. If you've got a few tabs that you always have open and then you always want to refer to it, maybe it's your LMS, maybe it's your email, maybe it's your Google Drive, pin those tabs. Pinning them makes them as small as they can get and then throws them to the left side of the screen. You can see the three pin tabs that I have over here already. Let's see how to pin a new tab. If I have a tab that I want to pin, all I have to do is right click on the tab and then just say pin. You can see how it moves it all the way to the left and then makes it as small as the tabs can get. And it just got added to the three pin tabs that I already had over there. Way easier to find them when they're all the way to the left and then really compact. Also, you can tell Chrome what you would like to have open whenever you open up Chrome. To see those options, you can just click on the three dots on the far right and then go down to Settings. And then on the left here, you see On Startup. You have a few different options. You can say, I just want a new tab to be open when I open up Chrome. You can say, continue where you left off, where it'll keep basically all of the tabs that you had last time you were on Google Chrome up on your computer when you come back. Or if there's a specific page or set of pages that you would like to add. And so if there's like an LMS, a Google Drive, Google Classroom, and you want those open every time, you would just say add a new page and then say what the website is, classroom.google.com, and then add that. So in this case, every time that I open up Google Chrome, a Google Classroom tab will be open. Now here's the interesting thing. If you pin tabs, they will open up next time you open up Chrome, regardless of what you pick here. So notice I have four tabs up here. I'm gonna say open the new tab page. So what that means is all of these non-pinned tabs should go away next time I open up Chrome and all I'll have is one new tab in addition to my pinned tabs. So let's see if it works. I'm gonna do Command Q. And now I'm going to click on Chrome. Who's using it? Because I'm using my profiles. It's my personal one. And you can see All of my other tabs that I had open are gone, but my four pin tabs are still there. So pin tabs are kind of like a workaround. If you want certain tabs always opened and you want them pinned, just keep them pinned. If you don't want them to be showing up anymore, or you don't want them pinned anymore, you just right click on it and say unpin. And so now let's see what happens. I unpinned that plan board website, command Q, open up Chrome. And now only the remaining three pin tabs are there. I actually learned that in research for this video, and I thought that was pretty cool. So maybe your American history students like to listen to chill hop radio, some lo-fi beats while they are working. So you added that to your American history group tab, and then you collapsed it. And then at some point during the class, you're like, oh, I need to pause that for a second. Where did I put that? I don't see it anywhere. You can use the media player icon on the top right of Google Chrome whenever anything's playing, and then you can see what's playing and then pause it straight from here. Go to the next track, whatever you want to do. So your profiles are set up, you've got some optimization strategies, you've got your house of tabs in order. Now it's time for
the omnibox.
Did you know that this little box up here is called the omnibox? There's a reason it's called the omnibox, because it does a lot more than just receive websites that you type in. First, it serves as a Google search. So if you're like classroom ideas, you don't need to go to google.com to do that. You just type it into the omnibox. You can also use it as a timer by saying how much of a timer you want, and then it'll show up right at the top. Use it as a conversion tool, 3 feet 2 inches. Simple math, 78 times 14. And right there, it actually shows you the answer before you even hit enter. Other cool stuff is you can create a new doc just from typing doc.new, sheets.new, slides.new. It works with any type of Google Doc. And you can also actually search other websites straight from the omnibox. For example, if I type in youtube.com and instead of hitting enter and then going to the YouTube search bar and searching something, I'm gonna hit tab. And you can see it says search YouTube right there. And now I'm gonna say new EdTech classroom. Now when I hit enter, it actually shows me the results of new EdTech classroom on YouTube. You can set this up for any website that you visit a lot and do a lot of searches on. All you have to do is right click on the omnibox and then go to manage search engines. And then you'll see a little spot that says other search engines. You'll click on add. You may see some already down there that I don't really remember how they got down there, but if you don't see any there, you can go ahead and click add. And then if I wanted to add YouTube as one of the things that I can just do youtube.com tab and then do the search, I could just say, okay, well, the search engine is gonna be YouTube. The keyword is what do you wanna type to be able to search YouTube? I'd keep it simple and just say youtube.com. So that way when I type that in the omnibox and hit tab, it'll search YouTube. Now this is the only part that seems a little tricky. I need to first go to youtube.com and then I need to do a search for anything. I'm just gonna do a quick search for ASDF, just random letters, and then hit enter. So the reason I did that is because I need to take this little URL at the top, and then that's basically the way YouTube does a search. That's the URL it gives me. I'm going to copy this URL. I'm going to paste that URL, and then where it says ASDF, that's the thing that I searched for, I need to replace that with a percent sign and an S, because that's what it says right here. Replace with percent S in the place of your query, in the place of your search. So erase ASDF, replace it with percent and then S, and then I'm gonna hit add. And now when I go to YouTube, or when I go to the omnibox, youtube.com, tab, and then I can search for whatever I want. This works for any website. And so at the end of the day, you want Google Chrome to actually look good as well. And so a couple things you can do for the appearance. The first thing that I like to do is kind of clean up my bookmarks bar. If you're not sure how to add something to the bookmarks bar, just go to the website you want to add and then click on this little star on the far right and then say add bookmark. And then it's gonna say, okay, what do you wanna call this? And then where do you wanna put it? Now, I could just call it New EdTech Classroom since this is the website for it. And that's what I did with all of the ones that are already there. You see the names of it, but it's so much cleaner to just leave the name blank. I'm gonna erase the name, click done. And now it's just an icon of the New EdTech Classroom tree. Maybe I wanna go ahead and take off the name of the ones that are already there. If I right click on them and then go down to edit, it says, okay, well, what do you wanna call this? I don't wanna call it anything. It's the Google Calendar icon, so I know it's Google Calendars. And then I'm gonna click save. And let me do that to the rest of them. And so that looks a lot cleaner, and you're gonna be able to add a lot more bookmarks. Of course, this only works if the little icon is like obvious what that is. If it's not, or if you've got multiple like YouTube icons, you will have to keep the name there. You can also make Chrome have a color scheme that kind of suits and matches your personality. I actually like to keep a color scheme that matches whatever profile I'm on. And so if your school colors are blue and white, then maybe on your school profile, you make it a blue and white color scheme. I'm on my new EdTech Classroom Google profile, and so I'm gonna make this one green. I'm gonna open up a new tab, and then down here it says Customize Chrome. You may just only see a little pen if it doesn't actually say Customize Chrome, but I'm gonna click on that. And then I can change my background. Now this background part is actually just for the new tab background. And so every time you open up a new tab, instead of being like blank with just the Google search bar, you can have these designs. I like these geometric shapes, and I'm gonna click on green for a new EdTech classroom, and I'm gonna click done. Now I'd still like to customize the colors of the tabs and stuff. So I'm gonna go back down to customize, and then I'm gonna click on color and theme. And let's do a light green for new EdTech classroom. And click on done. You are somewhat limited with the designs and the styles that are given to you straight from this customize section. But if you really want to explore the world of themes, you can just actually go up to these three dots and then go to settings, click on appearance here on the left. Right now it says Chrome colors, but I'm gonna click on that. And now it gives me this huge selection of themes that were not available on that original customization page. And so in keeping with the green theme, I'm gonna go with this green and blue cubes and click on that. I'm gonna click on add to Chrome. And now when I open up a new tab, it's got these, it's a little bit different than what I had, but I'm actually getting into the world of extensions and add-ons right here. And we've got a whole different video on the best extensions and add-ons for Google Chrome that you can check out right here. And so see you over in that video to explore the world of extensions and add-ons.